He was well on his way. It's just tragic. 20 years old, rest in peace, God bless Pop Smoke.
Look at this beautiful sunset. So right now I'm just doing 700 meters of vertical elevation with my bike. Because you know what, too much running is bad for me. I'm taking a rest and working back smartly.
So as you can see, after the incident, my last treadmill intervals, I didn't do any exercising in like 2 weeks. Did some jump ropes, some swimming, you know. As you can see here, I even just tried to get back into exercising. I did a challenge with my friend and I lasted 2 days. You can see how motivated I was to exercise during winter. But then I went to Spain with my friends. We did a lot of orienteering there. We did some forest orienteering, some sprints in towns. And that was actually my first orienteering camp that I've done in my life. And it was such an awesome experience. After the camp, my knees were so demolished, but at least I got motivation to train again. Yeah, what I started doing is exercising my hips, my inner thighs, as you can see, leg exercises. So basically, it has been already 3 months before I stopped exercising now, and I started doing like glutes, hips, and full body destruction, basically gym workouts. So yeah, my body started recovering. Then April came around, and I really tried to get back my fitness by doing leg core, some intervals, some weight running. As you can see, 8 kilometer tempo run, my first run in like 4 months, like actual training run, and then I was back.
Because me and Paulis we're going to a competition. We're going to a night relay competition in like half an hour. So we have to get ready. This will be the last practice before the Latvian champs in night, Orienteering. And Paul, are you ready for your first night running? Oh my God, you're hyped.
Because
we have this plan that he'll run JUKOLA first, like for single attackers. So he has to practice with my headlamp, and I will give the relay leg. I will give the pass to him, also by just transferring my lamp to his head and the battery. So it will be a challenge. It will be fun.
Yeah, the lamp is like a backpack.
Yes,
it will be really hard. Time to be gone.
Oh my God, this is my first time orienteering in the night this year. And look at the first control! I found a wrong forking and I made such a big mistake. Then I was just running alone, which wasn't that good at all. But like, look at this mistake! What? I didn't see the road? That this map was quite outdated and it was so horrible to run it in the night because you couldn't orienteer. There were just nothing, no orienteers. There is just a green forest. I think we're changing our sports. This was horrible. I made so many mistakes and I don't know how I'll manage to do anything tomorrow in the Latvian champs, but at least we got some practice for JUKOLA, right? That's the only thing that matters, and it's so bright I cannot see anything, but yeah, this was tough. Oh my God, yesterday Tampere Pirinto selected the JUKOLA teams and I'll be running in the third team. If the first two teams are running in the like elite teams, like actually they're fighting for top 10, then the third team is also really good. I don't know what they were last year, but I'll be running the last leg, which is the longest one. I have not ran that far in so long. It's like 17 kilometers, I think. How will I be able to do it? I don't know. But I'm just super excited that I'm in the third team. Okay, we're about to head out. We're about to go to the Latvian champs, the Latvian night orienteering champs. And I'll wear the Pinto shirt, you know, some preparation for JUKOLA drip. So let's go. Let's go to guys and count. The drip check. As I said, I'll be trying Pirinto shirt because I have not worn it for like this year at all. So considering yesterday's mistakes, this time I took it much more carefully. I mean, I was running together with a lot of people all the time, so it wasn't that bad. I was running with Walter Seneslats the first part of the course, and you can just watch his GPS because I didn't have the official GPS on me. So we caught up with Emilis right here, and then we just continued. The forest was actually like extremely green. Not too much, but I mean, for the night, it was quite green. And now we continue with the Emilis, since we had the same forking, same butterfly. And I was leading at this point, and as you can see, I made a mistake. So I can imagine my Emilis was quite mad about me. It was quite okay. I mean, then we just continued. But everybody was having mistakes, as you can see. And this climb was so horrible. I mean, at least we found control quite okay. We didn't manage to do the same thing on the way back, though, as you can see. We just ran sort of in the direction, but we messed up and we were all making mistakes. There were so many people because the central forking was so horrible, and we found the control at the same time. And now Emilis went to the opposite direction. I don't know why it happens, but I was running with Walters here, and mad respect to the guy because he ran all the way up Gaisenkalns, which is the highest mountain in Latvia. I was walking, I will admit that. So I ran straight, as did Chris Sipsiansens, and my plan was just go straight to the road, but I didn't.
I'll show you later what happened, but it was just a horrible last loop. I gave up on all of my expectations and I was running very slowly, and it was such a big mistake of mine, because if you can see the results, I was so close to top 4 and I was literally like half a minute behind the Valtteris, and if I would have pushed harder, maybe I could have caught Kristaps as well. So yet again, we learned that you never give up because others might have had a bad time as well. So that was so close. I got the 6th place and I thought I did very horrible. I mean, I was running with Emils all the time, but then we split up and the last part, as you can see, I can show you. So to the 21st, I was running here and then somehow I came out here. And then I was just very slowly finished the last part. But it turns out I was like 30 seconds behind 4th place. That's crazy.
Hey, my God.
Thank you.